So in this video, let us talk about the different types of acids in details. So the different types of acid means the classification of acids on the basis of their basicity. So monobasic acids, as you know, means if the molecule of that acid produces only one hydronium ion, that's a monobasic acid. So for example, if we take HCl, if you dissolve water to it, it will produce only one hydronium ion. As you can see the mechanism, the reaction I've written over here, and the chloride ion. What exactly is going on when HCl molecule dissociates? It produces hydrogen cation, that's proton, along with the chloride ion. Now, as you know that proton can't exist independently, they can't exist independently, and you have water molecule there as well in the solution. So this proton will get attracted towards the hydrogen, towards the water molecule, to produce hydronium ion. So you can see here that only one hydronium ion is produced by a molecule of HCl. That's why it's monobasic. Now another important thing, as it produces only one hydronium ion, then it will produce only one normal salt, only one type of normal salt. For example, if you take NaOH, HCl, so it will undergo, these two molecules will undergo a neutralization reaction. Water will be expelled from here, H2O, and you will have NaCl, normal salt. So you can see that only one type of normal salt is produced because the acid is monobasic. Now let us talk about dibasic acids. Dibasic acids are acids which produce two hydronium ions. The molecules of dibasic acids, they produce two hydronium ions in their aqueous solution. That is when they undergo dissociation. Okay. What are the examples? You have ample of examples. H2SO4, H2C2O4, H2SO3, H2CO3, and many others. H3PO3 also. Okay, so don't go on the number of hydrogen atoms. Okay, here you have two hydrogen atoms, but this is an exception. You have three hydrogen atoms. So don't go on the number of hydrogen atoms. Rather, the correct definition, the correct concept is that how many hydronium ions it produces, molecule of it produces. How many hydronium ions are produced by a molecule of that acid? If it is two, that means that's dibasic. Okay. So let us try to understand the mechanism. So when you take H2SO4, for example, it will dissociate into 2H plus plus SO4 2 minus, isn't it? And these two protons will get attracted towards the water molecule, to produce hydronium ion. Okay, I have not balanced the equation here. So it will produce hydronium ion. Now what exactly is going on? I have explained to you that the H2SO4 dissociates into the protons and SO4 2 minus, and these protons will get attracted towards water molecule to produce hydronium ion. Now I'm giving you the balanced equation, the chemical equation, to understand why it is dibasic, that is how it is producing two hydronium ions, H2SO4. So if you take H2SO4, it dissociates in two steps. In the first step, H2SO4 combines with the water molecule to produce a hydronium ion and HSO4 minus. Now again, this HSO4 minus combines with water molecule to produce another hydronium ion and SO4 2 minus. So you can see that H2SO4 undergoes dissociation in two steps and it's producing two hydronium ions in these two steps. That's why it's dibasic. Okay. Now, as it is producing two hydronium ions, that means it will produce, it will make two types of salts. One acidic salt and another normal salt. Example, NaOH, if you take NaOH and react it with H2SO4, it will produce NaHSO4 plus H2O and NaOH plus H2SO4 will produce Na2SO4 plus 2H2O. So you can see that H2SO4 at the very same time when reacts with NaOH is producing two different types of salts. Okay, two different types of salts. One is acidic and one is normal. Why the salt is termed as acidic? Because of the presence of this proton, because of the presence of this hydrogen. So when you find hydrogen atoms present in the molecule of the salt, that's acidic in nature. And we don't have, when you don't have hydrogen atoms in the molecule of a salt, that's normal. That's normal. Okay. Now let us talk about a very important concept, that why H3PO3 is a dibasic acid. Why this is true for H3PO3? Although it contains three hydrogen atoms, so outwardly it is showing you that it's tribasic, but it's dibasic exactly. Why? Because it produces only two hydronium ions in its aqueous solution. Why that case is so? Because if you to understand the concept, why does it produce two hydronium ions, you have to draw the structure of H3PO3, and this is what? Phosphorus acid. This is phosphorus acid, H3PO3, and H3PO4 is phosphoric acid. Okay, by the way, so phosphorus acid, if you draw the structure, it is like this. To understand why does it produce only two hydronium ions, you have to look at the structure. So when it undergoes dissociation, when the molecule of this undergo dissociation, phosphorus acid, this hydrogen does not get removed. This hydrogen, which is bonded directly towards the phosphorus atom, does not get removed. Rather, the two hydrogens which you can see over here, which are connected to the oxygen atom, get removed. So that's why it's dibasic, because you can't remove this third hydrogen atom. So if you can't remove three hydrogen atoms, you can't produce three hydronium ions. If you can't produce three hydronium ions, it is not tribasic. Only two hydrogen atoms can be removed from the molecule which are attached to the oxygen atoms. Okay, so hence they are dibasic in nature. Hope you understood the concept. Now let us talk about tribasicity. Tribasicity means a molecule of an acid will produce three hydronium ions, isn't it? Three hydronium ions when the aqueous solution, when it undergoes dissociation. For example, H3PO4, not PO3, it's H3PO3, C6H8O7, these are the examples of tribasic acid. Okay, why? Because they produce three hydronium ions in their aqueous solution. This is phosphoric acid, and this one is
citric acid. Now let us try to understand the mechanism which is undergoing on the molecular level. So H3PO4 will combine with water and will form a hydronium ion in the first step along with H2PO4-. H2PO4- will combine with water to produce hydronium ion along with HPO4-. Again, this HPO4-2- will combine with water to produce hydronium ion and PO4-3-.
So you can see that phosphoric acid is undergoing dissociation in three steps, and it's producing three hydronium ions in these three steps. That's why this is a tribasic acid. Now, how to learn this mechanism? How to learn this reaction? Very, very easy. You write H3PO4 plus H2O and H3O plus in the first step, H2PO4-. The radical H2PO4- over here. अब यहाँ पर आप देखिए कि H2PO4 को फिर यहाँ लाना है. You have to take this radical over here, cross, and again put water here, and then write H3O plus again. And अब करना क्या है कि H2 में से एक हाइड्रोजन कम कर देना है और ये चार्ज को बढ़ाते जाना है. टू माइनस, ये वन माइनस था, अब ये टू माइनस हो जाएगा. अगेन यू टेक दिस HPO4-2- ओवर हियर, अगेन कम्बाइन दिस विथ वाटर एंड यू विल मेक H3O प्लस अगेन, एंड हाइड्रोजन कम हो जाएगा तो हाइड्रोजन गायब भी हो जाएगा और यहाँ पर चार्ज बढ़ जाएगा. ओके, सो अनलेस एंड अनटिल यू गेट PO4-3- एज द लास्ट रेडिकल इन द लास्ट स्टेप, यू हैव टू कंटिन्यू एंड यू विल गो एंड H3PO4 विल अंडरगो डिसोसिएशन इन थ्री स्टेप्स. ओके, सो एज दिस इज प्रोड्यूसिंग थ्री हाइड्रोनियम आयन्स, सो डेफिनेटली इट इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सॉल्ट्स. टू एसिडिक सॉल्ट्स एंड वन नॉर्मल सॉल्ट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, NaOH, सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, रिएक्ट्स विथ फॉस्फोरिक एसिड H3PO4 एंड विल प्रोड्यूस NaH2PO4 प्लस H2O. दिस इज वॉट, this is an acidic salt because of this hydrogen atom, presence of this these hydrogen atoms. So this is what, monosodium dihydrogen phosphate. Another type of salt which it is going to produce is Na2HPO4 प्लस H2O. Na2H PO4 H2O. यू हैव टू बैलेंस दिस इक्वेशन एज वेल. ओके, सो वी हैव बैलेंस दिस. दिस इज डाई सोडियम हाइड्रोजन फॉस्फेट. ओके, so these are the two types of acidic salts which tribasic acid produces, and the normal salt is NaOH plus H3PO4 Na3PO4 Na3PO4 plus 3H2O plus 3H2O 3NaOH H3PO4 Na3PO4 3H2O trisodium phosphate. Now to learn these reactions, my dear student, it is very important to know the basics, that is the types of reactions. Okay, how to form molecular formula. Okay, how to react, and you have to know the basics of how reaction is written. Okay, and that is not in the syllabus, that is not in your 10th book, but it's very important. It's basics, it is the fundamental knowledge you have to understand chemistry, to have a grip, to master this subject.
And I promised you as well that I will teach you this, okay, as much as I know. So what I have intended is that I will upload the videos in my channel during the vacation. And I hope that all of you have subscribed it. Kindly watch it. It will help you a lot throughout the syllabus, inshallah. It will be a great help for you to understand the reactions. Okay, I will make you understand how to write the molecular formula. Okay, I will make you understand how to write the different reactions, how to balance the reactions. Okay, what are the different types of reactions? Okay, how to understand whether it is a phosphate or a phosphide or a phosphite or whatever. Okay, lots of confusions are there. So, inshallah, some of them, I'm not guaranteeing you that I will make you understand everything. Okay, some of the confusions, and that is more than enough in class 10th standard. It will help you a lot. So, watch those videos. I will upload in my YouTube channel. So, if you haven't subscribed it, it will be a great help for you, okay, to understand the reactions and to learn them very easily, inshallah.